First Alert Weather.
I thought I'd share a beautiful photo shared in our Idaho Weather Watchers page on Facebook, taken by Andrew in Horseshoe Bend, of the fog yesterday morning. Absolutely stunning picture, Andrew. Thank you. And we may get more photos like this tomorrow morning, as we do have more fog in the forecast. And in fact, it's already developed across portions of the Treasure Valley. You can see it here on our live shot of the connector in downtown Boise. Visibility less than a mile in portions of Boise right now. Temperatures at 50 degrees. Our dew point is at 48. And remember, the closer that dew point temperature gets to the air temperature, the higher that humidity is. And once they match, that is where dense fog will form. And that's exactly what we're seeing right now. So the Boise Airport, less than a mile of visibility. It's getting a little bit foggy out towards Caldwell and Nampa. So where the winds remain light tonight and where we saw precipitation over the last couple of days, which was pretty much our entire viewing area, can anticipate some fog to form. And speaking of precipitation, I know we're only 5 days into the month of November. Look at the rain totals, though, from the last several days. Boise and Ontario both up over half an inch. McCall, an inch and a half of precipitation over the last 5 days, I should say. Twin Falls, though, in Mountain Home, not much. 11 hundredths is all for Twin Falls. So it's really a case of the haves and have nots. But the numbers you see here, especially the higher numbers for Boise, Ontario, McCall, about half of what we normally see in the entire month. So yes, it's been a very wet start to the month of November, and we're going to add some more tomorrow. This is what's coming down right now. You can see lightning strikes still. We're getting some nocturnal thunderstorms just outside of the Long Valley. It looks like rolled through Washington County first, Baker County and Northeast Oregon as well. So we will continue to see showers filling in from southwest to northeast overnight. The system triggering all this activity is just off the west coast. It'll continue marching east overnight into tomorrow. So rain will arrive in Boise as early as maybe 3 to 4 o'clock in the morning. I would anticipate a wet commute tomorrow morning, a wet wait at the morning bus stop. We'll keep rain in the picture until about 4 or 5 o'clock tomorrow evening. After that, I think we'll just see scattered showers. Doesn't mean we'll dry up completely, but at least in Boise, Mother Nature may turn off the tap at that point. Temperatures will hit the upper 50s tomorrow, not as warm as our mid 60s today, and we will likely see more showers continuing in the mountains on into Tuesday. Snow levels will start at 7,000 feet tomorrow, dropping potentially down to about 5,000 feet by Tuesday. That means McCall could see some snow showers, maybe some accumulating snow on Tuesday before it all starts clearing out on Wednesday and Thursday. A little break in the action. Temperatures will warm a bit in the afternoon, not much. And then on Friday, we see that next round coming in. So by the time it's all said and done tomorrow into early Tuesday, look at the rain potential, precipitation potential, I should say. Some of this will be snow for places like McCall and Stanley. Not a big rainmaker necessarily for the lower elevations, but still just plan on dodging raindrops tomorrow. I don't think the umbrella probably got too far away since we've had such a rainy weekend, but just be ready for that tomorrow. Temperatures for the Magic Valley tomorrow, we'll see about mid 50s. Everywhere will drop maybe 5 to 6 degrees over what was a warm Sunday today. There's our scattered showers possibly Tuesday morning in the Boise area. Sunshine Wednesday and Thursday, but that allows for some cold mornings down below, freezing again Thursday morning. That next system, Carolyn, will sweep in late Thursday into Friday, bringing a chance of some showers back into the picture. So kind of an on again, off again type forecast. Pay attention every day because it does tend to change.
Sounds good. And I was really paying attention to what you're saying about the fog. Do you think it'll be pretty thick in the morning, or can you tell?
I think it will be. We call it patchy because it's hard to predict exactly where it will be at its most dense. Once it starts raining and the wind picks up a little, should scour it out. But still, I would anticipate it for tomorrow morning.
All right, for our morning commute. Okay, we'll be right back.